everybody. My name is Jo. Thanks for joining me again today. Today's lesson is going to be a little bit different because Carlo isn't joining us. He's decided to do his learning in the park today. I'm actually quite pleased about that because I've got so much work to do in my classroom before the children return to school, and I'm hoping today that you can help me with some sorting. I've bought some materials, some containers, a pen, and some paper, and I'm hoping you can help me design a solution to our problem. I'm wondering if you've seen these materials before. You may have actually had them in your kindy. They have a really special name that you might not have heard before. They're called attribute blocks. Attribute is a new word for lots of children. You might not know what attribute means. We can describe these blocks by their size, their colour, or their shape. I wonder if you recognised any of those attributes. Children in my class love to use these blocks to build and create, and that's actually a problem, and it's the problem we're going to talk about today. Because at the end of last year, the children said it was really hard for them to find the block they needed because all the materials were tossed in there together, and that caused a problem because they would tip all the blocks out onto the floor to find the one block they needed to complete their work. I wonder if that ever happens for you at home when you are searching for a toy in your toy box and you've got to tip the whole lot out to just find that one single toy. So today we're going to have a go at solving that problem. I really need you to help me with this sorting. If we have a look into the basket, we can see there is one really obvious attribute, one really obvious way in which we could sort these materials. Have a look and see if you can work out what that might be. I think you're right. Colour is a really obvious attribute. We've got yellow blocks. We have blue blocks. And we've got some red blocks. So we could sort the blocks and put all the yellow blocks together in one bowl, all the blue blocks together in another bowl, and all the red blocks together in the last bowl. That could be a really good solution to this problem, except for, I'll actually tell you something really important. When I watch children playing, they don't very often choose just yellow blocks to play with, or they don't very often choose just blue blocks to play with. So colour is not a very effective way of sorting these blocks in my classroom. I wonder if there's another attribute that we notice in our basket today. It's not colour, but I'm going to hold these up for you because I found a, do you know what that shape is? A square, you're right. We have some squares and we have some triangles and we have some circles. And they're the only three shapes we have in the basket today. So I'm wondering if shape is an effective way of sorting these materials. So we've got one container for the squares, one container for the triangles, and one container for the circles. But we've still got a few more materials that we have to sort out. How do I know that this shape belongs in the circle container? I know it's a circle because it has one continuous line that runs around the outside of it. It's different to the triangle because you can see the triangle has points or edges on it, and the circle has one continuous line around the outside. I'm wondering how many other circles are in my basket. Let's just check. One continuous line. I think that belongs in that container. Another continuous line. And another. So that means we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 5 circles. How can we identify a triangle? Let's have a close look at this one. We know that a triangle has 1, 2, 3 corners. And help me count. 1, 2, 3 sides. Let's see if we've got any other triangles in our basket. We'll check. 1, 2, 3 corners. Help me count. 1, 2, 3 sides. Another triangle. We'll check this one. Help me. 1, 2, 3 corners. And 1, 2, 3 sides. Another triangle. Let's count again. 1, 2, 3 corners. We're getting faster at this. 1, 2, 3 sides. This time, I'm not going to count. I'm going to measure them against each other. And look, I can see that they match. So I'm pretty sure that's a triangle as well. Let's put them in the tray and let's count. Can you help me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 again. One to go. So I'm guessing all of these shapes belong in the last bowl. Do you know what that shape's called? It's right, it's a square. And how do we know? It's got 1, 2, 3, 4 corners, and it's got 1, 2, 3, 4 sides. Let's put it in. Let's use the new strategy that we've developed. We know that's a square. Let's see if it matches. Perfect. 4 corners, 4 sides. There's only one shape left in the basket. Let's try again and see if that matches as well. Can you see? 4 corners and 4 sides. Let's pop that into the tray and let's do a final count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fantastic. So we've sorted today using shape. We have squares in one container, we have triangles in the second container, and we have circles in the third container. We have one more problem. When I return these materials to the classroom, how are the children going to know that that container holds the squares, that this container holds the triangles, and that this container holds the circles? How am I going to stop the children tipping all of the materials back into the same basket again? I have one idea, but I'm hoping you could help me. How will they know these are squares? I think I heard somebody say you could write the name of the shape and put it on the shelf in front of the containers. I think that's a fabulous idea. I've got the names of the shapes here. Circle. Triangle. And square. The only problem there is that when children first come to school, they find it really challenging to read these long words. So I'm not sure that that's the best way of labelling. I heard somebody say you could trace around the shape and stick it on the front of the container. I think that's another fabulous idea. But I actually heard one more. I heard somebody else say you could take one shape from each container and blue tack it on the shelf in front of each of the containers. Then people would know exactly what's inside. They are all fabulous ideas, and I'm going to have a think about what might work best in my classroom this year. And I'll get back to you next time. Before we finish, I've got a song I want to share with you today. I'm hoping you can help me. You might have heard this song before. One of these things is not like the other. One of these things doesn't belong. One of these things is not like the other. Can you guess which one? Did you guess this thing is not like the other? Did you guess this thing doesn't belong? Did you guess this thing is not like the other? Then you're perfectly right. The banana is, in some ways, it's the same. It's the same, you're right. It's the same color. It doesn't taste the same. And it's certainly not the same shape. Thank you for joining me today. Don't forget, you have a home task to do. Are you listening carefully? Today, you're going to go searching. Searching for the circle shape, indoors or out. You might see it, you're right, on the wheel of your car. You might see it inside the car as your steering wheel. You might go searching for triangles indoors or actually outdoors, because I think I've seen that shape before on top of my house somewhere. And it seems to me that squares are everywhere. So get searching indoors and out, and we look forward to hearing from you tomorrow. Thanks for joining me today, everybody. Look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Bye.